get the job done. But I'm here to tell you that the future of the United States is not going to be determined in the prairies of Afghanistan. The future of the United States, whether you want to recognize it or not, is going to be determined by how well prepared we are to compete in a highly competitive 21st century. And that battle is going to be waged across the Pacific Ocean. We've got some work to do, ladies and gentlemen. So as you walk out of this building, I want you to remember why we are in this race, because it is about the generation that we're about to pass the greatest nation that ever was to, and the condition in which they're going to find it. And I want you to know that for me, the priorities are going to be debt and spending, because we have no choice. It is totally unsustainable, the trajectory that we are on. And two, the reality of launching a new industrial revolution. It is within our grasp. It has happened before in our nation's history. A hopeful, optimistic, problem-solving people can do it again. We need leadership, and we need a game plan. And number three, we got to get our position right in the world. Finally, let me just say, we need someone who's electable. We've got to pull together as a party. If you want to win in 2012, we got to have numbers. This is about addition, ladies and gentlemen. This is about addition. We've got to pull together around what our core needs are for this country in 2012. And I'm here to tell you, I can be your person. We're going to win this race, and we're going to work tirelessly and endlessly, not only here in Florida, but in New Hampshire and in South Carolina as well. These are the three states in which we're going to be camped out for a very, very long time. We are absolutely committed to cause. We are moving forward with great enthusiasm and gusto. I ask for your help and support, because I have to ask for your help and support. If ever you want the most humbling experience in the world, you think announcing for president in front of Lady Liberty is a humbling experience, that's a humbling experience. You want to feel that kind of emotional jolt within when you announce for president of the United States of America in front of Lady Liberty? That's a pretty awesome experience, I got to tell you. But you want another awesome experience that is truly humbling? Ask somebody for their vote. Because you know that's the most important thing that in our system they have to give you. And they're going to look at you, and they're going to analyze you, and they're going to stew and fret and talk and size you up, and all of that should be done. And all I'm saying is, I'm running on my record. Take a look at what I did in the state of Utah. Take a look at what we have done during our public service career. I'm not running for my record. I'm running on my record. So ladies and gentlemen, it would be a great pleasure to have you on board. We're going to work you hard. If you don't see Mary Kay and if you don't see me here, you're going to see one of our seven kids, and you're going to get darn tired of meeting the Huntsman clan. We've got the multiplier effect that's going to take place in Florida. Our deployment patterns are going to be pretty darn powerful and pretty darn awesome. Thank you for allowing us to be here today. May God bless America.
Wait, listen, I ask, but it's simple to me. I like studying American history. And I think easily what happened to this country is that one of the greatest minds in the world found this nation when they wrote the Constitution. And every president, Democratic and Republican, has gone away from the Constitution. And what we really need to do is get back to the Constitution. That's all.
Let me just point out one very important aspect of that as we ponder federalism, the 10th Amendment. And as we talk about the role of the states going forward, as a governor, I would have to tell you that one of the most important things we could do, whether it's health care reform, somebody talked about repealing Obamacare. Here's what we need to do. Here's the answer to health care reform. You're not going to solve health care reform in one sitting, which is basically what has been tried. $1 trillion dropped on us over the course of 10 years. The states in this republic of ours have got to find solutions, and it's going to take a few years. But the laboratories of democracy are going to find how to close the gap on spending. They're going to find ways to deal with the uninsured. They're going to figure out how to harmonize medical records, taking costs out. We'll find the solutions. But one of the things that I'm taking from your comment that has resonated since I was governor is the power of the states in finding solutions longer term. Thank you.
Governor, I have two questions. One, will you stand with Israel?
Of course I will stand with Israel.
And will you make a commitment today that if you are elected, you will immediately repeal every executive order that Obama has ever signed?
Yeah, buddy.
That sounds right, and I'm going to follow up and get back to you. I just talk about Israel for just 1 second. Because I mentioned getting it right with our allies. As the Middle East is going through this transformational change, I liken it to the end of the Ottoman Empire, 1919, 1920. Sweeping change in the Middle East back then, you know, from Tunisia through to the Gulf and beyond. This happens periodically. There are changes in leadership, dictatorships who have hung out too long, who haven't delivered opportunity and economic growth to corners. We're going through it again. I don't know why we're in Libya. I can't figure that one out. This is a change. This is a change that is going to play out over the next, I don't know how long, but we're probably not going to get clarity on what the Middle East looks like for another 5, maybe 10 years. All the while, we've got to remember who our centerpiece relationship is in the Middle East, and it's Israel. And we have to remember that the expectations on the peace process, we can't wish for peace more than they wish for peace right now. They're in a difficult, unpredictable set of circumstances where the people they're negotiating wish them ill, and where the region is in such flux that nobody knows what Egypt is going to look like in the years to come. So how can you conclude anything of permanence when you're in the sea of change right now? We've got to hang with Israel during this time of need. And remember that longer term, we're going to need some partners in this world who believe in economic vitality and job creation. That's first and foremost for us. And two, counterterror. People who get the part about counterterrorism, because we're not fighting a nation state, we're fighting subsidiaries. And they're popping up here and there. And sometimes they're loosely affiliated with other organizations, they're funded, they're anti-American, and we need to make sure that we are partnered with people who are as fervent in their drive against terrorism as we are. Thank you.